I'm Anil Kumar. Let me thank all the subscribers and viewers, and especially Irum for posting this particular question based on set theory. We'll try to understand Venn diagram with the help of this particular question. In a school, 120 boys play cricket. 80 are batsmen and 48 are bowlers. Find the number of players which are both batsmen and bowler. We call them all-rounders. So find the number of players which are both batsmen and bowlers if all belong to either of this group, right? So either of this group means all are players, right? Either they are batsmen or bowlers. Part B. Find the number of players which are neither batsmen nor bowler if number of all-rounders is same as only number of bowlers. I should have written is same as number of bowlers, only bowlers, right? So these guys are not all-rounders, they're just bowlers. Okay. C. Largest possible number of boys who are neither batsmen nor bowlers. So that makes it very interesting. And cricket is a favorite game for me. So let's talk about it. So that's the box which represents all, right? So we can always say this is a set, and we normally write it as a universal set, right? So in this case, we'll call this as P, set of all the players. Now we have two groups here. One group which represents the batsmen, and the other group which represents bowlers. In between, we have all-rounders, correct? In between, we have all-rounders. So this number in between is all-rounders. Okay. Now let's look into it. Find the number of players which are both batsmen. That means both batsmen and bowlers means all-rounders. We want to find the number which is common to both. If all belong to either of this group, that means all 120 boys, they are either batsmen or bowlers or both, correct? So this number is very simple. If I add 80 batsmen with 48 bowlers, what do I get? So I get 8 in addition to 120. I get 128. Now the question is, why do I get these 8 extra, right? So I'll take a minute to explain this part also. So we have to understand inclusion and exclusion principle. So when we are adding bowlers and batsmen, all rounders are counted twice, right? So all rounders, this particular group in between is counted when you're counting batsmen, and it is also counted when you're counting bowlers. So it is counted again, twice. So those are those extra people here in our group. And that is what we want to find, right? So how many are all-rounders? So straight away, we get our solution. That is that extra number 8, right? So we can say 128 minus that extra number, 128, okay, minus 120 gives you 8, correct? So that is the answer for part A. So I hope that part is clear, correct? Now, in this we have assumed that nobody is outside, correct? So all 120 are either batsmen or bowlers. Now, some of you must be thinking, like, how can somebody be outside? Well, there are fielders, right, which are neither batsmen nor bowlers, right, but they are good all round, just the fielders, right? So they are outside. Okay, part B. Find the number of players which are neither batsmen nor bowler if number of all rounder is same as the number of only bowlers. Now we have twisted this question a bit, which makes it very tricky. Now we want to find how many could be outside, right? That is to say, let me sketch it again and explain you the concept. So we again have the same group, but this time there is a condition. And the condition here is that find the number of players which are neither batsmen nor bowlers. That means outside batsmen and bowlers, neither batsmen nor bowlers, right? If number of all-rounders is same as number of only bowlers. So this is number of only bowlers, correct? And this number. So these two numbers are same, correct? So to begin with, let's say we already have the numbers as 80, 48. So there are 48 bowlers in all. So put them same means half of them will be inside, which are common, and half outside. So basically, we can split it like this. We could have 24 here, and inside we could have 24 because of this given condition. Now the number of all-rounders and number of only bowlers are both 24. You get the idea. Now we also know that there are 80 batsmen in all. So how many will get into this group? We are calling this group as the persons who are batting and these are bowling, right? So batsmen and bowlers. So the batsmen remaining will be 80 take away 24, and that gives you 6, and when you take away 7, take away 2 is 5, 56 in all. So that becomes the total number of players who are either batsmen or bowlers, correct? If all rounders and bowlers are same. So let's add this group. So we have to add 56 with 24 and again 24, the three groups. 6 and 4, 10 and 4, 14, 1, 6 and 4, so 6 and 4, 10. So we get 104 here, but we have total 120 players. So clearly, 120 take away 104, which gives you 16, is the players outside, correct? So the answer for this is 16. So I hope that makes sense, correct? Now let's talk about the last part, which is largest possible number of boys who are neither batsmen nor bowlers, right? So now we're looking for a different scenario altogether. So we want to maximize the people who are kind of fielders, right? So largest number, possible number of boys who are neither batsmen nor bowlers. So we want the group, the maximum number, which could be outside these specialists, right? So that is what we are looking for. Now, how could we figure this out? Now, one way to look into it is that we know that 80 are batsmen, correct? And 48 are bowlers. So the best thing could be that all 48 are common. So if I put those 48 right there in the intersection, then I get zero number, only bowlers, and that will minimize this particular set. So what I'm left with here is we have 80 batsmen, so we have to do 80 minus 48, correct? So 80 minus 48 will give me 32, correct? So this 32 is outside of this group. So those are the only batsmen. 48 are bowlers and batsmen, all-rounders. So that is the number minimum engaged in this particular group. So now we can find what could be maximum outside. So I hope you get this idea, right? So the outside is definitely 120 take away 32, take away 48, correct? So that is basically 120 take away 80. So we remain with 40, correct? So that could be the group of fielders, right? Specialist fielders outside. So we get the answer 40 for part C. So I hope you understand and appreciate how varying these conditions, we could actually make the question very interesting as it is. So Arun, thanks a lot once again for posting such a beautiful question. I didn't had like this in my set of videos, so it is definitely going to enrich and help many of the viewers and subscribers. Thanks for watching and all the best.